of a white Christmas.
Dave Quinn, Jen Lawson, and Sasmo are here tonight in a mental battle to see who can win the Tournament of Champions. For a chance to win Joe's Dollars from our sponsors, Joe McFadden of Aviat Hall and Joe Voorhees of Aviat Hall. Now, here's your host, Brad Price.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
Awesome. Yeah. Filthy human. Yes.
Well, welcome everyone to the game show. The rules are simple. You've all been on the show before because you were all champions. But you leave today all losers, except one. Assuming. Now, we'll start off the show. Dave, I believe your midget won the death match, so you get to start off first. Choose a category and a dollar sign. The dollar signs aren't real. It's just, you know, for the folks.
Christmas for 400.
What was the original name for the poem The Nightmare Before Christmas? No! It is A Visit from St. Nicholas. Wrong. Go ahead, Dave. Next one.
Christmas for five.
Couldn't nail the 400. Getting greedy going for the five. Who produced the first charity Christmas card? Anybody? Sasmo? Anything?
Nothing.
Shame. That's a shame. It's actually UNICEF. All capitals. Stands for something. Jen, you choose something.
Simpsons for 300.
All right, let's go. All right, here we go. I'm playing a voice. You've seen me in such videos as Who Am I?
Troy McClure.
Correct! Jen
Filthy
nailed the
woman.
300 points.
Filthy woman.
You smell asthma.
Jen, if you will.
400 for Simpsons, please.
400 for Simpsons. What is Mr. Burns' first name?
Charles.
Oh, man. Nails it. Next.
I'm going to be greedy, too. 500.
500? Simpsons.
Yes.
How many kids does a Pooh have?
8.
Yes! Sasmo nails it. 8. All right, Sasmo. Boy, the board is yours.
Well, well, it seems my reign of terror will begin now. Simpsons for 200.
Simpsons for 200. What is the sea captain's name?
McAllister.
Correct. Captain McAllister is also acceptable. Next one, Sasmo.
I will finish it. Simpsons for 100.
Here we go. What is the name of Bart's evil twin?
El Barto.
Wrong!
Oh. Hugo?
Yes! In your face, Sasmo. Jen, board.
Christmas, 100, please.
Christmas for 100. What was the first year that electric Christmas tree lights were used in? Sasmo.
How is anyone, no matter what species,
oh
supposed to
God.
Know this?
Oh my God. Around this time of year, too.
1945.
Wrong. Jen?
1940?
It's 1895.
Oh, my God.
1895. Yeah. So that was the $100 question. Anybody care for the $200? Jen!
$200.
$200 question. Here we go. Who was Scrooge's deceased business partner in a Go ahead, Seth.
Marley.
Does he have a first name? Whatever. Sasmo gets it. Jacob Marley, aww. Yes.
I knew it was something.
The 300 on Christmas? Anybody care?
No.
Okay, sure. Here we go.
Whatever.
The $300 question on Christmas. Who's the Nutcracker's main enemy? The Nutcracker's main enemy.
That rat thing, like the Rat King. I don't know.
Well, I guess If Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles had a spin-off of Nutcrackers, it would be the Rat King. So yes, I'm going to give you that. It's actually the King of the Mice.
Oh.
All right, same thing. But right now, we're going to go to a commercial. So when we get back, we'll learn a little bit about our guest for the kickoff. Hey everybody, and welcome back to the game show. Right now we have Jen Lawson in the lead with 1,300, Sasmo 700, and Dave. Well, let's get to know Dave. Dave, so I hear you're building a rocket ship. What's that for?
No, I'm not.
How about a submarine?
No.
You don't like submarines or rocket ships?
No.
I hear you like a whale on the guitar.
No.
Interesting. Jen, what are you doing for Christmas?
I'm going down to Florida to spend some time with my family. Go to Disney.
Florida?
Yeah.
It's gonna snow on Christmas. It doesn't snow in Florida.
No, it doesn't. Not often.
I guess you could bring your own for a few amount of time. Sasmo, what's your Christmas substitute on wherever you're from?
On my planet, we have no Christmas. We value things such as destruction and death, not worshiping a fat man who smells of vomit and brings you presents.
Very merry of you. Well, let's get back to the game. Jen, since you have the lead, we're going to have Dave pick the category.
Oh, holy shit.
Anything from the 80s trivia, Dave. Go for it.
80s 100.
All right, here we go. What is the name of the car in Knight Rider?
Kit.
Yes! That is correct. Dave, what was yours?
200.
200, here we go. What does ALF stand for?
Alien life form.
Yes. Way to be on that one, Sasmo. Right. Next one.
300.
Okay. What was the name of the bar in Dukes of Hazzard?
Didn't watch that show.
Dave, take a guess.
I have Toothless Ancestry.
We're gonna give you that one. It's a boar's nest, but that, you know. The owner of the boar's nest also opened that bar as well.
Awesome.
Dave, next one.
Whatever. 400.
Okay, 400. What was the date in 1955 Marty McFly arrived on? Date.
November 5th?
Correct!
Oh!
That was huge. That's huge. All right, Jen. All you got is 8,500.
500.
All right, here we go. What is the more common name for the car with the model name DMC-12?
The DeLorean.
Correct. Dave comes up big. And let's go to our judge to see the tally up scores, to see. Really? Dave with 900. Jen with, what was it, 1,900? 1,900, and Sasmo screwed over with 700. Sasmo, you're going to have to leave. And when we go back, we'll go to the lightning round with Jen and Dave.
These two meat rats will not forget this. Their destructions will be first.
Whatever, Sasmo.
Yeah, fuck
we'll
you,
be back.
Oh my God, I didn't give a shit.
You're going to explain the lightning round.
Welcome back to the game show. Right now, it's time for the lightning round between Jen and Dave. So let's get into that. Jen and Dave, the lightning round is worth 500 points each question you get correctly. Are you all set?
Yes.
Jen, since you have the lead, you get to pick the first category in which we lightning.
Acronyms, please.
Acronyms. All right, here we are. When I read the question, the lightning round begins. Here we go. What does the internet connection DSL stand for?
Direct service line.
Wrong. Jen?
Direct.
Wrong.
Oh.
Next one. What does HTML stand for?
Hypertext Markup Language.
Correct. Next one. What does AT&T stand for?
Atlantic something.
Close. Dave.
Ooh.
It is American Telephone and Telegraph. Number four, if an ambulance driver tells you he's responding to an MVA, what is he responding to?
Motor vehicle accident.
Correct. Thank you, Voorhees. What does BMW stand for?
Bavarian Motor Works.
Awesome. There you are. Here we are. Time for one hit wonders. Woo! Are we all set? Okay, now I'll name the song. And you name who sang it. Ready? Here we go. I'm going to be 500 miles.
Oh, the, those guys with those glasses. Those big dorks.
Anything better, Dave?
The Pretenders?
Oh, close, close. It's the Proclaimers.
Oh, I knew it began.
You were both equally close to the dorks.
Yeah, leave it to the Scottish.
Number two, I'm Too Sexy.
Right Said Fred.
Correct. Number three, Take On Me.
Aha.
Correct. Number four, Tainted Love.
Soft Sell.
Correct. Number five, Come On, Eileen.
Oh.
It's Dave.
Texas Midnight Runners.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
My bad.
Lightning round is over. We're waiting for the judges to tally up the scores. Dave with 2,900 and Jen, the whopping 3,400. Jen, you will go into the championship lightning round. Dave, thank you very much for playing.
No problem.
Second. The champions. When we come back, the final round with Jen. Stay tuned. Hey, everybody, and welcome back to the game show. Time for the final round with Jen Lawson. Watch the questions there. I'll read her 10 questions. You get 7 of them correct. You win the Joe's Dollars. Sponsored by Joe Boris, Gilman Fan. Are you all set? Judges, if you please put a minute on the clock. Excellent. And we will begin when I first start reading the first question. You can pass anytime you want. We'll go back to them if we have a minute left. Blah, 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 blah. Number one, here we go. Who's the president of the university? Correct. What is the Japanese name for the long, wide-sleeve robe worn mostly by Japanese women?
Kimonos.
Correct. How many chevrons are on Stargate?
7.
Wrong! What high school did The Rock graduate from?
Pass.
Who is the god of war?
Oh, Eros.
Who is the inventor of the Apple computer?
Jobs. Steve Jobs.
Yes. What? Apple released a computer named Lisa. Who was named after it?
Lisa Simpson?
No, it was his daughter. In which 2002 Winter Olympic sport did the United States win its first gold medal?
Skiing.
No. What are the two software applications used for cell phone video games / programs?
No idea.
Who owns Mazda?
Pass.
All right, what high school did Rock graduate from?
Berkeley.
That time is up! Time is up, judges. How many did she get correct? Judges. She got only 4 correct. I'm sorry, you got the snowboarding was the first sport they won in 2002. Ford owns Mazda, of all things. And The Rock went to Freedom. But that ends the show. Thank you very much, Jen, for being on the show. And if you will, we'll send him off. Do it, Rockapella! You can plan right, Corey, music. On me. Christmas. Please have snow and Rusty, Alyssa DeVito, and Eric Troxell here tonight to see who can get the most amount of questions correctly in one game show. And now here's your host, Brian.
Hello and welcome to the game show. We've got three categories tonight: mythology, weather, and past Super Bowls. The game is simple. You just pick a question, I'll ask it, and you get points if you get it right. After the first round, whoever is losing gets tossed. After the coin flip backstage, we determined that Rusty gets to choose the first question. Take it away.
I'll take mythology for 100.
All right. Who is the god of gods in Norse mythology? Eric?
Zeus.
Wrong. Anybody else? The god of gods. Odin. Okay, nobody got that, so back to Rusty.
Keep going with mythology for 200, please.
Who is the Roman god of night? Well, all right. The answer was Nox. Nox.
Keep going.
All right. What is the name of the half-man, half-monster in Beowulf? For 300 points.
Grendel?
All right, Grendel. 300 points for Rusty.
Woohoo!
Gonna keep going.
Mythology, please.
All right. Who is the Greek god of the sea? Rusty.
Poseidon.
Okay. Another 400 points. Again with the mythology. All right. Who solved the riddle of the Sphinx? Rusty again.
Oedipus Rex.
Good deal. All right. Guess pick another question in a different category now.
Weather for 100.
Okay. What U.S. city is the most windy city? Rusty.
Chicago?
I'm sorry, it's... Oh, wait. We have to do... anybody else? Yeah. Mount Washington, New Hampshire. Okay.
Well, Rusty again? Guess weather for 200, please.
Okay. What state in the U.S. is home to the city with the most snow? Eric.
Colorado.
I'm sorry. No.
Alaska?
Nope. Alyssa, you care to give a try at all? All right, looks like we're going to commercial break. Oh. When we come back, we'll meet the contestants. Okay, welcome back to the game show. Time to meet our contestants. Rusty, you've got 1,200 points. And I hear you haven't showered or brushed your teeth or even changed your clothes in the past 6 months. How's that going for you?
The stairs. The stairs are the worst. And people going like this. It's. I live my lifestyle how I want to.
Certainly an offensive smell. Alyssa, you haven't buzzed in at all this game. Are you afraid that we're going to find out you're horribly unintelligent or have bad breath?
Absolutely. Not the bad breath part.
Okay. And Eric, you're sexually attracted to jack-o'-lanterns. How do your parents feel about that one?
I mean, what can I say? Something about a jack-o'-lantern just, you know.
No, I don't. Okay, now here's Brad to remind us what Alyssa and Eric certainly won't be winning.
Well, Brian, today's grand prize. Winner will take home $25 to Giant Food Stores on Route 309, and if not, you'll get a 6-inch sub from Subway, also on Route 309. Back to you, Brian.
Okay, Rusty, you were leading us when we went to, you had the board when we went to commercial break. you like to choose a question?
Well, let's mix it up and go to past Super Bowls for 500.
Oh. Crazy. Who won Super Bowl I in 1967? Rusty.
The Dallas Cowboys.
No. Oh. Anyone else? Eric.
Green Bay Packers.
That's correct. 500 for Eric. All right. If you're done gloating, do you pick another question?
Give me a...
We don't have all day.
200 Super Bowls.
Super Bowls for 200. Who won in 2000? Anyway. Eric.
The Eagles.
Nope. Alyssa. Can't lose points.
No idea.
Rusty.
Green Bay?
Nope. New St. Louis Rams. I believe, Eric, you want to pick another one?
Yeah, I'll go for 100 for the Super Bowls in the past.
Okay. Who won in 2004? Rusty.
That would be the New England Patriots.
Correct. Your choice.
Past Super Bowls for 300, please.
Okay. Who won in 1996? Eric.
The Eagles.
No. Alyssa.
The Packers.
No.
Nice. The Eagles.
The Dallas Cowboys. I don't care. Go ahead, Rusty.
Yes, Super Bowls for 400, please.
Okay. Who won in 1992?
Who were the Dallas Cowboys?
No, and you don't have to answer in the form of a question.
Oh, right, okay.
You may or may not be losing points for that. anybody else? Eric.
Dallas Cowboys.
Nope. Can't answer twice. Alyssa, name a football team you like the colors of. Anything.
The Cowboys.
No. All right. Rusty, something from weather.
I don't care. Pick one.
No, I will not.
400.
What type of front moves the fastest?
Cold front.
That's correct. All right. Okay, weather for 500. What is the U.S. state with the hottest city? Rusty.
Florida.
No. Anyone else? State. Eric.
Texas.
No. Alyssa.
Hawaii.
No. Correct answer was Arizona. Yuma, Arizona. Now I suppose we'll go to commercial break. And... oh, yeah. Tally up the scores. Are we done? Welcome back to the game show. We had to say goodbye to Alyssa, who left with the lowest score in game show history, if you can even call that a score at all. Time for the lightning round. Eric, you won the tennis match backstage. Pick a category.
I'm going to have to go for the internet jargon, please.
Okay, first question. What does .com stand for? Eric.
That would be dot communication.
Wrong. Rusty, don't buzz, just say it.
I don't know.
Okay, commercial. Commercial.
Damn.
Two, what does WWW stand for? Eric.
That would be World Wide Web.
Correct. What does HTTP stand for?
That would be Hypertext Terminal Protocol.
Are we accepting that? No.
Ha!
Rusty.
Not a clue.
Oh, we're taking it. We're what? Taking it. All right, that was close enough. It was Hypertext Transfer Protocol. What does HTML stand for? Just say four words.
It's already buzzed.
Just say it then.
How did I do that?
I don't know.
All right. Hyper, what, HTML.
HTML.
Text.
This is the lightning round.
Media link.
No. Rusty.
Clue.
Hypertext markup language.
You suck.
What does FTP stand for?
What?
FTP. Eric.
File transfer protocol.
Correct. Okay, now on to internet, on to spelled like what?
I'm on fire.
Damn it.
Mississippi. Eric.
M. I. I. M. I.
Lightning round.
S. I. M. I. S. S. I. M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-I.
Incorrect.
Aha! M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I.
Correct.
Woohoo!
February.
F-E-B-R-U-A-R-Y.
Correct.
Woohoo!
Encyclopedia. Eric.
E-N-C-Y-C-L-O-P-E-D-I-A.
Correct. Capacitor.
C-O-M-P-A.
Wrong.
Not even close.
Damn.
Eric.
C-A-P. Repeat the question.
It's not a question, but capacitor.
C-A-P-A-C-I-T-E-R.
Close, but no. Hors d'oeuvre. You buzzed before.
H-O-U-R.
No.
H-O-R-D-E-R-V.
No.
E.
No.
E.
All right, that's the end of the lightning round. Somebody's winning at this point in time. Oh, spell it. Hors d'oeuvre. H-O-R-S space. D apostrophe O E U V R E. Failure. And Eric is the winner.
No!
He will move on to the final round.
No!
Okay, we'll go to commercial.
I'm number one.
No!
I'm number one.
No.
Welcome back to the game show for our final round. Eric, you have 1 minute to answer as many of these 10 questions as you can. Answer 7, and you get a fabulous Subway sub. Answer all 10, not only do you get the sub, but you also get a $25 gift certificate to Giant Foods.
All right. All right.
Glad you're enthusiastic about that.
All right.
All right. Question number one. When DeSales first opened, who was not permitted to attend?
Girls.
Correct. What is Dorothy's last name in The Wizard of Oz?
Pass.
What is Barbie's last name?
Steve Vincent.
How many feet are in a mile?
12. No. 7.
What is the 7. Boiling point of water on the Celsius scale?
I don't know what that means.
What color is a giraffe's tongue?
Blue.
What company created products such as Tyvek and Teflon?
Playtex.
What is the school's address?
Station 2755 Station Avenue.
In?
Allentown, no. Center Valley, Pennsylvania. 18037.
Correct. What was the name of President Clinton's cat?
Boots.
Time out.
Boots!
Get out of here. I'm sorry, you answered 2 of the 10 questions correct.
Oh.
And you get nothing. That's it for the game show. We'll see you next week or the week after.
God damn it, I knew it!
Bob Eccles, Tara Reminold, and Ernie Justice are here tonight to see who will mentally reign supreme at the game show. Now, here's your host, Brian.
Thanks, Brad. Our game here is simple. We've got 3 categories in the first round, at the end of which the 2 winning contestants will go on to the lightning round, after which the winner will face some kind of odd challenge in the throne. Bob, you caught the greased pig backstage. Would you like to pick our first question?
Yeah, I want to go with alcohol.
Okay.
For what?
What is can... Oh,
for I need to pick the value, too. Let's do 300.
All right. What is contained in a white Russian?
Kahlua and cream.
Correct. Oh, incorrect.
What?
Yes, incorrect.
I work at a bar.
Kahlua and milk?
Yeah, sure.
Nice. Then I get to choose again.
Now I'm pissed.
Yeah, go ahead and choose again.
We'll do alcohol for 500.
Okay. What is contained in a blowjob?
Sarah. Bailey's Irish Cream and Kahlua, and I think that's it.
No.
I give up. People don't know how to make drinks around here.
Anyone else? Can't lose points for answering wrong. Okay. Coffee liquor and whipped cream.
All right.
That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
Bob?
That's not correct.
I get to choose again.
It's not correct.
Let's do money for 100. Sweet.
Which former president is on the $1 bill?
George Washington.
All right. Tara.
What did he pick? Money for what? What was that?
100. You picked money for 100.
Okay.
You may pick another question.
All right, I'll pick money for 200.
Which former president is on the $5 bill?
Abraham Lincoln.
Correct.
Can I please pick money for 300?
Yes, you may. Which former president is on the $2 bill?
Shit.
Next time you buzz in early, I'm not even finishing the question.
Thomas Jefferson.
Correct.
Oh my God.
Pick again.
Can I please have money for 400?
Who is on the $1 gold coin that was recently issued? Ernie.
Queen Victoria.
No. Tara.
Sacagawea.
Correct.
Oh.
Can I please have money for 500?
Who is the only non-president on paper money?
Ben Franklin.
Incorrect.
I think he's right.
Okay, correct. All right, we're taking that one. Okay, we're gonna go commercial break. Can we get the scores first? Judges are tallying up the scores. Still working on that one.
Good job, Ernie.
I didn't even know that one.
I am pissed about this basketball. I will.
Okay, we got Tara in the lead with 1,000. That's spaced incorrectly. Followed by Ernie at 500 and Bob with 300. Welcome back to the game show. Right now, Tara's in the lead with 1,000 points, followed by Ernie with 500 points, and Bob with 300 points. And now's the time on our show when we get to know the contestants.
And I'm slacking.
Bob, your parents were brother and sister. Has that had any adverse effects on your life?
Just a tail.
Fair enough.
Right,
Tara, last year you lost to a puppet.
I hate you, Tracy.
How do you feel about that?
I'm bitter, but I say the Dracula was biased towards Hector and the puppet.
Or maybe you're
just
stupid.
They were in a coalition. And I'm stupid, that too.
Ernie, you spent several years as a groupie for the band Motley Crue.
Sure have.
How did that go for you?
Well, it was a very joyous experience, and I regret it. I really regret it.
Yeah. I would too. Okay, on to the rest of the first round. Tara, you're in the lead, so why don't you start us off?
Cookies. For 300, please.
Okay. How many chocolate chips are in a bag of Chips Ahoy? Tara.
1,000.
Correct.
I'm such a dork.
Just pick another question.
Cookies for 400, please.
What kind of cookie is a snickerdoodle?
Tracy Meeker.
Incorrect.
Tart. Santart.
No.
It's Tracy Rieger.
Bob, can't lose points.
I don't even know what to say to what kind of a cookie. So.
It's Tracy Rieger.
Sugar. Tara, go ahead and pick another one.
Can I have cookies for 500, please?
In 1 year, who sells more cookies, Girl Scouts or Oreo? Ernie.
Girl Scouts.
Correct. The board is yours.
Oh, sweet. Cookies for 200.
What is the most popular Girl Scout cookie?
Thin Mints.
Correct.
100. Cookies.
What cookies are made by elves? Ernie.
Keebler.
Correct.
Oh, my God.
Darn it, Ernie. Eat
your cookie. Oh, crap. 100. Alcohol time. Yeah.
What is contained in a screwdriver? Tara.
Vodka and orange juice.
Correct.
Yes.
Take another question.
Alcohol for 200, please.
What is contained in a Long Island iced tea?
Coke, sour mix, vodka.
You're way off track.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Anyone else?
Iced tea and liquor.
No. Okay, we're giving it to Tara.
Thank you.
Probably just because she whined about it. Okay, we got alcohol for 400. What is contained in a Manhattan? Manhattan. Anybody? Okay, whiskey and Rommel. That's the end of our first round. We get the scores. Okay, Tara's in the lead with 1,500 points. Ernie's in second with 1,300 points. Ooh. And Bob, you'll be leaving with a meager 300 points.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Okay, we'll be right back with the lightning round. Welcome back to the game show. Tara is ahead with 1,500 points, with Ernie trailing close behind at 1,300 points. And before we start the lightning round, let's have Brad tell them what they're fighting for.
Well, Brian, today's winner will take home a free Subway sandwich from Subway via Route 309 and a grand prize of $25 to Giant Food Stores if they win. Here you go, Brian.
Okay. During the commercial break, our judges determined that Tara had the most back hair, so she'll pick our first category for the lightning round.
I would like Adam Sandler movies.
Please. Okay. In which movie does he fall in love with his third grade teacher?
Tara. Billy Madison.
Correct. In what movie does he say, "Who's your buddy?" Scuba Steve.
Big Daddy.
Correct. In which movie does he run a pizzeria?
Mr. Deeds.
Correct. In which movie does he date a girl with no short-term memory?
51st Dates.
Correct. In which movie does he attempt to stab someone with an ice skate?
Happy Gilmore.
Correct. On to acronyms. What does PDA stand for?
Public Display of Affection.
Are we going to take that one? No! Tara. Come on, Tara.
Thanks, Joe.
Says Joe.
I'm just going to keep
personal
on this one.
Digital assistant.
Oh.
My bad.
What does PSI stand for?
Pounds per square inch.
Correct. What does DPI stand for? Dots per inch. What does NSA stand for? National Security Agency. What does SCUBA stand for?
Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus.
Correct.
I think you just kicked my ass.
I think I just did.
Thank you. Okay, judges, what are the scores?
Come on, Tracy. Help me out, Tracy. I know you want to. If that's twice, I'm going to quit.
You know I kicked you.
I think you just kicked my butt.
I did.
You totally just
I ripped
my
you
butt.
Apart.
Maybe the answer to maybe
Whoa!
I just got my butt kicked.
Yeah. Ernie is in the lead with 3,100 points, crushing Tara's meager 1,900 points. Ooh. Tara, you're going to have to hit the road. We're going to go to commercial break, and we'll be back with Ernie
Good
in
job.
The final round. Welcome back to the game show. We've got Ernie in our throne. Ernie, you're on your way to a 6-inch Subway sub if you answer 5 questions, 2 6-inch subs if you answer 8, and a gift certificate to Giant if you answer 10.
I'm going for it.
You've got 1 minute and 10 questions.
All right, I'm ready.
All right. Who is the president of DeSales University?
Father O'Connor.
What is DeSales' phone number?
610-282-1100.
In what year was Aviat Hall built?
19...
Nope. Who owns NBC?
Time Warner.
What does Carpe Diem mean?
Seize the day.
What year did the Soviet Union collapse?
1967.
What state is Bruce Springsteen from?
Tennessee.
What movie did Mel Gibson win 2 Oscars for?
Braveheart.
What year did Fidel Castro come into power?
1960.
What is the smallest country in the world?
Vatican City.
Okay. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 questions correct. Woo. So you've got yourself a 6-inch sub. Woo. How do you feel?
I feel hungry.
That's great. Get the hell out of here. Are we cut?
Gina, Sean, and Greg are here tonight competing for a possible Subway sandwich and $25 to Giant Food Stores. Now, ladies and gentlemen, here's your host, Brian.
Thanks, Brad. We've got three categories in our first round tonight. The Oscars, number one hits, and literature. The two highest scoring contestants at the end of the first round will go into the second round, after which the highest scoring contestant will go on to the final round for that Subway sandwich. Okay. Greg, you won the coin toss backstage. Why don't you pick the first category?
Let's go with number one hits for 500. Oh.
What was rock legend Chuck Berry's only... Greg?
Mike Dingling.
Wow, that's correct. Pick another category.
I'll go with the Oscars for 100, please.
Tom Hanks won two consecutive Best Actor Awards in 1993 and 1994.
What is Philadelphia and Forrest Gump?
Correct again. Pick another one.
Go Oscars 200.
All right.
Name the film which earned Al Pacino Best Actor in a leading role.
Right. Godfather.
Incorrect. Anyone else? Can't lose points.
Can't lose points.
Pinocchio.
Al Pacino.
I know, I can't guess it.
What's wrong with you? Is
it,
it's,
what? I couldn't think of anything.
The answer was Son of a Woman. Greg, you have pick another category.
Oscars 300, please.
This film starring Morgan Freeman took home Best Picture in 1989. Greg.
Glory.
Incorrect.
Morgan Freeman.
Gina.
Field of Dreams?
No.
Morgan Freeman? No answer. Let's find out what it is.
Sean.
Don't Stand By Me.
Driving Miss Daisy. Greg, another category.
Oscars 400.
In 1992, she won Best Actress in a Supporting Role for her work in My Cousin Vinny.
Oh, Marissa Tomei.
Correct.
I don't think my buzzer works.
She knew that one.
My buzzer doesn't work.
You got the score, Mike?
You want to pick another category?
Yes, Oscars 500, please.
This man could not personally accept his Oscar for Best Direct.
We'll get it. The guy did so. Peter Jackson.
Can you continue? I'll finish the question now. Or Gina wants to.
George Lucas?
No. Can I finish the question?
Finish the question for me, please.
This man cannot personally accept his Oscar for Best Director in 2002 because he would be arrested if he entered the United States.
Oh, I knew it too.
Well, you should have waited.
Yeah. And
can we give Sean points for like?
Yeah, for waiting.
Being patient.
Wait, there you go.
Wait, I know who it is though.
Doesn't matter. Roman Polanski. Greg, pick another one.
Let's go number one hits, 100, please.
Who has had more number one hits, Elvis Presley, The Beatles, or Michael Jackson? Greg.
Beatles.
Correct. All right, we're going to tally up the scores before we go to commercial. How do you guys think you did?
I think you're losing.
I'm the only one who's got points.
Maybe?
Yeah.
Let's just see about it. You might be doing all right. Okay. Greg has 1,100, and the rest of you have nothing.
Yes, it is true.
All right, we'll be back after these commercials. Yeah, well, I can't get myself to go away. Welcome back to the game show. The scores again are Greg, 1,100, Gina and Sean, nothing. Now we'll go ahead and meet the contestants. Gina, you're failing despite the fact that you tried to look at the answers before the game. How does that make you feel?
Oh, that's slander, my friend. That's not
right. We all
right.
saw it.
That was true, I saw it.
Sean, you're from California.
Yes, sir. I am.
That's great. Greg, you are selling yourself to pay off your gambling debts. How's that going for you?
It's going pretty good. Beating these contestants, I'll be here next week to play again.
Well, I'd be glad to help you out.
If the show's still on.
All right, Greg, you had the board when we went to commercial. Why don't you go ahead and pick a category?
Okay, we'll go with number one hits for 200.
Okay, who had a 15-year absence from the number one spot until he reached it again in 1993 for I Would Do Anything for Love.
Meatloaf.
Correct.
Oh, I like that song.
Shoot.
All right.
I like that song.
If I don't score, I'm going to act on the second round.
Janie's got 200 points.
Yeah, okay. All right. I'm happy about that. All right. You got a problem.
Go ahead and pick another one.
Literature for 300, Brian.
This writer is best known for the Lord of the Rings trilogy.
Tolkien.
Correct. Pick another category.
We'll go with number one hits for 300, please.
Rob Van Winkle made this the first rap song to hit number one.
Ice Ice Baby.
Correct. Pick another category.
Number one hits for 400.
Which duo had more number one hits? Sonny and Cher or Hall and Oates?
Hall and Oates.
Correct.
That's right.
Darn it.
I'll take literature for 100, please.
What is Dr. Seuss' real name?
On my thing.
Dr. Seuss' real name. Theodore Geisel. Pick another one.
Literature for 200, please.
In Romeo and Juliet, what does Juliet use to kill herself? Greg. Actually,
poison. Or
incorrect.
Dagger.
All right, correct.
It's a knife.
Pick another category.
500. Literature, please.
What is the name of the deceased girlfriend in Edgar Allan Poe's The Raven?
Oh.
Anybody?
Anne?
Nope.
Mary?
No.
Claudia?
Lenore?
That was close.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
Okay. And the last category is literature for 400, even though the rest of them are still up there. J.K. Rowling became popular with this series of children's literature.
Harry Potter.
Correct.
That's right, you don't really stick around.
I stink.
Okay, now we'll take some time.
Score.
Judges are going to tally up the scores. How do you guys think you did now?
Did better, but yeah.
How good can you do?
We'll see, won't we?
All right.
That's great.
See who's getting out of here. All right. Greg's in the lead with 1,700. Woo! Followed by Sean with 800.
There we go.
And Gina's not coming back with 400. Goodbye, Gina.
What can you do?
We're going to go to commercial break. And we get back, we're on to round two.
There we go.
Okay, welcome back to the game show. It's time for the lightning round. Greg is in the lead with 1,700 points, followed by Sean with 800 points. We had to say goodbye to Gina because she didn't know any of the answers. The questions are worth 500 points each. Sean, why don't you go ahead and pick a category?
Why don't we try theme parks to start us off?
Okay, what attraction at Disneyland travels the fastest?
Jaws.
Finish it. Okay. Space Mountain or Splash Mountain?
Space Mountain.
Correct.
Jaws.
What killer whale is the main attraction at SeaWorld?
Shamu.
Correct. This park in Pennsylvania is the oldest in America.
Six Flags.
Incorrect.
Hershey.
Kennywood. Which ride at Disney World takes place in an elevator at a hotel?
Tower of Terror.
Correct. Which attraction at Disney World has the song Yo-Ho, Yo-Ho, A Pirate's Life for Me?
Pirates of the Caribbean.
Correct. Okay, on Urban Legends.
Questions.
This movie was rumored to have a crew member hang himself during one of the shoots.
Wizard of Oz.
Correct. The New Jersey Devil was supposedly born in what town?
Newark.
Incorrect.
Trenton?
Pine Barrens. According to some myths, this candy mixed with soda.
Pop.
Let me finish the question.
Excuse me?
You forfeit your chance.
All right.
This.
But I knew the answer, so.
Doesn't matter. This candy mixed with soda can be fatal.
Pop Rocks.
Correct. Some believe that Walt Disney's body is currently where?
Is that me?
Yeah, go for it.
Buried under Disney World, Bob.
Incorrect.
It's a small world.
Frozen in a cryogenic chamber.
No idea.
This myth claims that you can get a kidney dialysis for the poor in exchange for what part of an aluminum can?
The cap, the clicker thing, the cap, the snapper.
Are we taking that?
What are you guys going? Thank you.
All right, we're taking that.
It's a technical term.
Judges, tally up the scores before we go to commercial. How do you think
you
did?
Good run there. That was good.
It was a good run. It was a good run. But I think he came in.
This might be a close one.
Pop Rocks, right? I know. You know theme parks. Though,
there you go.
You know theme parks. All right.
And the score is Greg, 3,200. Sean, 2,800. It was a close game.
Good job.
All right, we're going to go to commercial, and we're going to come back with Greg in the final round. It's time for the final round. Greg, you'll have 1 minute to answer as many of these 10 questions as possible. Answer 5, you got yourself a Subway sub. Answer 7, you got yourself 2 Subway subs. Answer 10 questions, that's a $25 gift certificate to Giant. Are you ready?
Right.
All right, let's get started. Who was elected Prime Minister of the United Kingdom in 1997?
Tony Blair.
Who killed John Lennon?
Pass that.
What is the largest planet in our solar system?
Mars.
When did man land on the moon?
1969.
Oh, yeah. Como estas is Spanish for what?
How you doing? I don't know Spanish.
Who wrote Of Mice and Men?
Oh, I know that. Oh. I'm going to go back to it.
What are the first 5 numbers of pi?
3.14 repeating.
32 degrees Fahrenheit is equal to how many degrees Celsius?
0.
Astronomy is the study of what?
The space, stars.
This leader is best known for crossing the Italian Alps with elephants.
Oh, I know him. Hold on. Not Hannibal. Damn it. Hannibal or something like that. Hannibal or something.
All right, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 questions correct.
Yeah!
That's a Subway
stop.
Damn.
Yeah. I got that Hannibal one wrong. Was that Hannibal?
Hannibal was correct. Damn.
I know who's right. Of Mice and Men. Oh, wait, are we still on?
You got, we'll be back, I guess, 2 weeks from now with another episode of The Game Show.
going to rumble!
Welcome to the game show. I'm Pope John Paul, the Nasty. Our contestants, Megan, Sylvia, and Tim, are competing once again for either a 6-inch Subway sub, 2 6-inch Subway subs, or a $25 gift certificate to Giant. Our game is simple. We've got three categories for the first round. The loser at the end of the first round will not go on to the second round, and the loser at the end of the second round will not go on to the final round. Can't lose any points for getting them wrong. That said, Tim, why don't you go first?
I'll take NBC for 100, please.
Okay. This NBC drama follows the Pryor family living in 1960s Philadelphia.
What is American Dream?
American Dreams is correct.
You almost lost.
Do not answer in the form of a question.
Sorry.
Pick a category.
NBC for 300.
This sitcom took place at fictional Blush Magazine.
I know it.
Can I buzz in? Yeah.
You know it? Answer.
Spin City.
Megan.
Spin City?
Incorrect.
Oh.
No, Sylvia.
That's what I thought it was, too. No. Not about you.
No, I know.
Just shoot me.
Just shoot me.
Oh, God, damn it.
Megan, you still get to pick a category.
Okay, NBC for 200.
This NBC sitcom is about producer Jake, who has to revive the worst morning show in Miami.
Good Morning Miami?
Correct.
Yeah, I thought I won.
Pick a category.
Let's go Greek mythology for 300.
Where is the home of the Greek gods?
Mount Olympus?
Correct.
Oh, okay. Greek mythology for 200.
King Midas had to turn anything he had the power to turn anything he touched into what?
Gold?
Correct. Pick another category.
Let's do taglines for 200.
Okay. To know Lloyd Dobler is to love him. From what movie?
No clue.
Say anything. Sylvia, you can pick another category.
Sitting into it. Taglines for 300.
The bride is back for the final cut.
Bride of Frankenstein?
Incorrect.
I don't know.
You're awful. Kill Bill Volume 2.
Oh, good. Does your thing work?
Sylvia, pick another category.
Greek mythology for 100.
Who was the wife of Odysseus who faithfully waited 20 years for his return?
Hermes?
Incorrect. And laughable. Anybody else?
Could you repeat the question?
No. Who was the wife of Odysseus who faithfully waited 20 years for his return? The answer is Penelope. Penelope. Okay, we're going to tally up the scores real quick before we go to commercial. How do you guys think you did?
Horrible. Absolutely horrible.
I pretty much am gone.
Hermes.
Still waiting on the scores.
All right.
What's your favorite color?
Pink.
I see.
Blue. What do you know?
And green.
That never works. All right. The scores before we go to commercial are Tim, who is a loser with none, apparently. Meg in second place with 100.
Ooh.
And Sylvia, our returning loser, in the lead with 700.
Whoa.
Good job, Sylvia. We'll be back for the rest of the first round after this commercial.
That's fine.
Welcome back to the game show. Our current scores are Tim in third place with 0. Meg in second place with 100, and Sylvia, the returning loser, with 700 in the lead. I forget who was picking at the end, but Sylvia, why don't you go ahead and pick a category?
Let's take NBC for 400.
Okay. This sitcom about high school friends aired its first episode on August 20th, 1989.
Saved by the Bell.
Correct. Please wait for me to finish the question.
You'll
lose points. Pick a category.
Taglines for 100.
One ring to rule them all.
Lord of the Rings?
Correct. Pick a category.
NBC for 500.
This sitcom about three interns trying to become doctors won two Emmys in its...
Sorry. Is it Scrubs?
Yes, it's Scrubs. Pick a category.
Greek mythology for 400.
Who is the god of the underworld?
Zeus?
Incorrect.
That's
no.
God of the
world. Yeah.
It's not your subject.
No.
So, Hades?
Hades? Correct.
It's coming to me.
I know. I was like,
all right, well, you got it.
Hades.
Get over it. Pick another category.
High Lion for 400.
You'll laugh, you'll cry, you'll hurl. Wayne's World.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Nice.
I'm disgusted. Pick another category.
Mythology for 500.
Who is the god of love?
Aphrodite.
Incorrect. Tim.
Athena?
Incorrect.
No.
Meg, can't get one wrong.
I'm thinking Aristophanes, but
that's so wrong.
No. Eros.
We just had that question.
Too bad. Taglines for 500. He always wanted to be special, but he never expected this.
The AI?
Incorrect. Teen Wolf. Very outdated question.
I'm gonna kill Jeff.
Okay, that's the end of the first round. We're gonna tally up the scores now and see who's gonna have to get out of here.
You got the 500 on. That's pretty good.
Nuh-uh.
Oh, I
only got 100. You got 500.
Oh, then you got the
500. Hey, you made it to me. How about that?
Gone.
All right, scores at the end of the first round are Tim in third place with 100. So at least he's got something. Meg in second place with 400. And Sylvia in the lead with 1,500.
Oh, yeah.
Congratulations, Sylvia. We're going to a commercial. Tim, you better be gone by the time we get back. Okay, welcome back to the game show. Our current scores going into the second round are Megan behind with 400 and Sylvia in the lead with 1,500. Before we get in the lightning round, we're going to go ahead and get to know the contestants a little bit. Megan, you were gang raped by a pod of whales in holes you didn't know you had. How's that going for you?
It was very pleasurable experience.
Say, not the best fishing trip, huh?
No, it wasn't.
No, no. So Sylvia, now that we brought dumber people on the show so that you could actually maybe win, you think children will stop spitting on you?
Hopefully. It's getting really annoying.
Okay. That's nice. You know, a little down note for Meg, a little up note for you.
Oh,
okay.
Man.
Sylvia, go ahead and pick category since you're winning.
I'll pick musical instruments.
Okay. First question. The fiddle is another name for this common string instrument.
Violin.
Correct. The black keys on the piano are used to play what type of notes?
Sharp.
And? Are we taking it? We're taking it.
No.
Ryan gave me a thumbs up and he's lying. Okay. We're not taking it.
Okay.
Sylvia.
I don't know.
Sharps and flats. The lute was the predecessor to this string instrument.
Cello?
Incorrect.
I was gonna say that too. The harp?
Incorrect. The guitar.
Oh.
Can't buzz in twice. How many keys does the average piano have?
52.
Incorrect. That's how many weeks in a year. 88. Is the piano percussion or a string instrument?
String.
Incorrect.
Percussion.
Whoa.
Correct.
Yes.
That was clever. Okay. On to outer space. Stop giggling and get ready.
Oh no.
What are meteor showers made of?
Comets?
Are we taking it?
Yeah.
Yes, debris from a comet, correct.
Nice.
A celestial body that has a gravitational pull so great that nothing can escape is called what? Nothing can escape, not even light.
Black hole?
Correct. How often does Halley's Comet return?
Meg, I'll let this one answer.
Yeah, it's all you.
Every 100 years?
Incorrect, every 76 years. What is the closest star to the Earth?
The Sun?
Correct. Who was the first person to put a telescope to practical use? Incorrect.
Oh.
Nope. Galileo. All right, let's tally up the scores. How do you guys think he did?
That might be close. Absolutely horrible.
I think it might.
Musical entrance?
I don't know if it's close or not. Is it going to make it? Oh.
All right.
Okay. At the end of the second round, Megan, you've got 900 points. You're out of here.
Yes.
Sylvia, with a whopping 3,500 points. Surprised us all.
Yay.
You're moving on to the final round with a chance to win a Subway sub, two Subway subs, or even a $25 gift certificate to Giant.
Yes.
We'll be right back with the final round on The Game Show.
I'm hungry.
Welcome back to The Game Show with our final round. Sylvia, you're going to have 10 questions in 1 minute. Get 5 of them right, you got yourself a 6-inch sub.
Yeah.
7 of them right, you got yourself 2 6-inch subs. 10 of them right, $25 gift certificate to Giant. Final round, American flag throne chair. Please don't let your country down.
I hope not.
First question. Betelgeuse is a star in which constellation? How many calories do you consume when you lick a stamp?
One.
Correct. What is Nicolas Cage's real name?
His name's not Sophia. Francis. Copia. Something. I forgot. Copia.
What is the top selling month for chicken noodle soup?
Top selling what?
Month for chicken noodle soup.
November?
Incorrect. Has Pabst Blue Ribbon beer ever won a blue ribbon?
No.
Incorrect. What is the diameter of a hockey puck?
4 inches?
Incorrect. How many different animals are there in animal crackers?
8.
Incorrect. How many dots are there on a pair of dice?
6.
Incorrect.
6, 7, yeah.
Grossly incorrect. Who wrote the stars? We're out of time. We're out of time. Go ahead and kill yourself. That was awful. All right, you've won nothing. We'll be back with the game show again in two weeks, I guess. Or the end of the year. Thanks for watching. Thanks, guys. Hey, you don't even have to move your feet. Just shake your thing, let me see you move. Now spin around and feel the groove. Let's try it. Hey, welcome to the game show, PA episode. We got three people here, Patrice, Michelle, and Andrea. We got a simple game here. First round, loser at the end of the round gets kicked out. Second round, loser at the end of that round gets kicked out. Final remaining contestant goes on to the final round in the throne. Don't lose any points for getting one wrong, so go ahead and guess. Andrew, why don't you go first?
Sure. Can I have circulatory for 200, please?
Sure. This brings blood from the lower half of the body into the heart.
The inferior vena cava?
Correct. Pick another category.
Can I have pharmacology for 300, please?
Okay. For pharmacology, we're going to go over what this medicine treats. I'm going to name a medicine. You guys tell me what it treats. Ambien.
Insomnia.
Correct. Pick another one.
Can I have respiratory for 200, please?
Sure. Administering oxygen this way, patients can receive 10 to 15 liters. Shell.
Non-rebreather mask.
Correct.
Pharmacology for 200.
Claritin cures what?
Allergies.
Correct.
Can I have pharmacology for 400, please?
Epinephrine.
Allergic reactions.
Correct. Wow.
Can I have circulation for 300, please?
Okay. These provide a path for blood to take after leaving the heart.
Veins?
Incorrect.
Arteries.
Correct.
Ooh, leave Woo. Me.
All right, back up here. Pick another one.
Can I have respiratory for 100?
Okay. When you breathe too fast, you are?
Hyperventilating.
Correct.
Okay. Respiratory for 300.
The amount of air you move in one breath is called?
Tidal volume.
Correct.
Pharmacology for 100.
Okay. Paxil cures what?
Depression.
Correct. Okay. We're going to go to commercial. You want to get the scores real quick before we go to commercial? So how do you guys think you did?
Oh, I got a nice zero.
Nothing to be proud of.
That's all right.
All right. Not a big mystery here, but Patrice is behind with zero, failing. Michelle in the second with 500, and Andrea with 1600. We'll be back in a little bit. Don't ring the buzzer. Okay, welcome back to the game show. The scores again are Patricia in last with zero, Michelle in second with 500, and Andrea in first with a muscular 1600. We're going to go ahead and get to know the contestants now. Patrice, you've really been kind of an embarrassment to the human race here. You think you'd do a little better if we had some questions about maybe shapes or colors or?
That would help a lot.
Okay,
that's
nice.
Yeah, then I could do a lot
better. All right. Michelle, earlier you told our producers that Satan's okay once you get to know him. You want to maybe tell us a little bit about that?
I'd have to kill you, so I really don't want to talk about it.
That's terrifying. And Andrea, you once dated an entire soccer team in one weekend.
Okay, so I was a little drunk. But I only dated a few soccer players. Two or three.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Whatever. All right. Back to the game.
Can I save the crown jewels?
Andrea, you had the board when we left, so go ahead and pick one.
Can I have circulatory 100, please?
Sure. Sure.
Just kidding.
The proper term for a blood pressure cuff is this.
Sphygmomanometer.
Correct.
How am I supposed to know this?
Glad I didn't have to pronounce that one. Okay. Okay. Pick another one.
Pharmacology 500.
Okay. Narcan.
Narcotic overdose?
Are we taking that? Yes, we're taking that. Big enthusiastic guess. Okay.
Judges?
Go ahead and pick another one.
Circulatory for 500.
Okay. The aorta receives its blood supply from the...
So, can you repeat the question?
Okay. No, it's okay. Shh. The aorta receives its blood supply from the... a part of the heart.
You should know this, girls. Let's go.
The left ventricle?
Correct. Big surprise.
Okay. Respiratory for 400.
This occurs when the body's cell and tissue do not have enough oxygen. When the body's cell and tissue do not have enough oxygen.
It dies?
Incorrect. Patrice, you want to maybe just guess? Say a big word you know.
I'm an L.Ed. major. I don't know big words.
That's pretty obvious. Okay. Hypoxia. Hypoxia.
Yeah, you guys should have known that one.
Yeah, don't act like you know it. You didn't know it. Okay, anybody pick another category?
Patrice.
Oh, all right. Let's go for circulatory for 100.
We did that one.
Oh, wait. Did we do that one?
It's still up there.
We can make up a question.
Okay, I believe. Oh, okay. Last one. Respiratory for 500. You. Hey, take it easy. Stop it. No giggling. It's a game show. It's about science. Your backup system for breathing to control respiration is called.
Patrice, she dug in.
Come on. This answer.
You better do a darn good job on this one, Patrice, or you're out of here.
I lose?
Okay. Hypoxic drive.
You should have known that.
Hypoxic drive. Okay, we're going to go to commercial. Let's get the scores real quick. I think I have a pretty good idea who's not coming back. All right. And the scores at the end of the first round are Patrice with 0.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Michelle still with 500. Yes. And Andrea with 2,700. Okay, we'll be back after this commercial break. Okay, welcome back to the game show. Patricia, who left with a score of 0, is gone. Hopefully she'll be able to find her way home. Michelle is in second place now with 500, and Drea is in first place with 2,700. Okay, Michelle, I can smell you from over here, so why don't you start us off and pick a category for our lightning round?
Acronyms.
Okay. I'm just going to read down a list of acronyms, and you know, somebody just buzzes in. Either one of you can and buzz in and give me the answer. ER.
Emergency room.
Correct. OR.
Operating room.
Correct. MICU.
Medical intensive care unit.
Are we taking it?
I don't think M is medical.
No, we're not taking it. Try harder. Any other guesses?
I can't buzz. Maternity intensive care unit?
Incorrect. Mobile intensive care unit.
Mobile.
DNR.
Do not resuscitate.
Correct. Finally. AED.
Automated external defibrillator.
Are we taking it? We're taking it. Right. Okay, that's it for acronyms. Now on to pregnancy and childbirth. Ready? This is when pregnancy occurs outside the uterus.
Oh, she wasn't done. Reflexes.
Well.
She's disqualified.
Lose 100 points. Andrea, she's in trouble. This is when a pregnancy occurs outside the uterus, most commonly in the fallopian tube.
Ectopic pregnancy?
Correct.
I don't think my buzzer works.
It does. You were
buzzing. When a child is born backward, it is this type of birth.
Breech.
Correct. This procedure is used when a child is literally cut from the womb.
Cesarean section.
Correct. Within 30 minutes of delivering a baby, this should be delivered.
Placenta.
Correct. Damn it. What happens when there is a prolapsed umbilical cord?
The oxygen can be cut off to the baby?
Incorrect.
That is correct.
Oh, we're gonna accept it. We're gonna accept it.
Told you.
Okay.
Better answer.
That's tough, isn't it? Yeah. All right, let's go ahead and get the scores real quick before we go to commercial break. Stop buzzing. Take another 100 points off her. I'll just subtract you when I get.
You can throw it.
All right.
He's got a baseball player.
Let's see who goes on to the final round.
Oh, I don't want to.
Okay, Michelle, you are in second place with 3,500. Drea just barely in the lead with 3,600. Could add. No, she could add 3,800. But she had to act out. But you still won by 100 points. Almost lost it. Okay, so we're going to go to commercial break. And I don't care for that. Okay, we're going to go to commercial break, and when we come back, Michelle will be gone. Thank God. Okay, welcome back to the game show. We are preparing for the final round, the throne. I'm gonna ask you 10 questions, Andrea. Get five of them right, you get a 6-inch Subway sub. Seven of them right, two 6-inch Subway subs. All 10, $25 gift certificate to Giant.
Nice.
You're in the throne, you got nobody to sit next to and giggle with anymore. This is just hardcore question answering.
Okay.
All right, we're gonna start.
Okay.
This long triangular cloth has many uses in the medical field.
Turban? Turpin.
Incorrect. This is where deoxygenized blood comes to refuel.
To the left atrium in the heart. Or right atrium.
Incorrect. The medical term for a rapid pulse is? I'm skipping it. If you have hypertension, you have a?
High blood pressure?
Correct. When you have epistaxis, you have a?
Nosebleed.
Correct. Dyspnea is?
Painful, difficult breathing.
Correct. Angina is?
Chest pain.
Correct. The peaks in an EKG are called?
The QRS waves.
Correct. Correct. What is the problem if you have a pulmonary edema?
You have fluid in your lungs.
Correct. Ecchymosis is?
Bruising.
Correct. Okay, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 correct. That's 2 6-inch Subway subs. Way to prove yourself on the game show. All right, we'll be back. I guess this is our last episode, so we'll be back next year with a whole new exciting season of the game show. Congratulations, Andrea, on your 2 subs. Catch you later.
Gabby Wilson, Zoe Bulu, and Patrice Aprisco are here tonight to clash heads to see who has the greater knowledge in random useless facts. Here tonight on The Game Show. Andy Wertner.
Thank you very much, Brad, and welcome to The Game Show. I'm filling in for Brian Brubach. We don't know where he is, but I can only assume he's recycling something. Alrighty. In case you don't know how the game works, basically we have 3 rounds. At the end of each round, one of the contestants is eliminated. And then at the end of the show, there's a lightning round with the final contestant to see if they can get the prize. Now let's go to Brad to find out what that prize is.
Well, Andy, tonight's prize is a $20 gift certificate to Giant Food Stores. Giant located on Route 309. That's it, Andy.
What a fantastic prize. All right, let's get started with the show. Now, Gabby won the Andy kissing contest backstage, so she will be picking the category. The categories are Summer Olympics, TV shows, and 80s music. Go right ahead.
I'll take TV shows for 100, please.
All right, television shows for 100. What are the first names of Starsky and Hutch? Starsky or Hutch, how about that? And out of time. No, that is wrong. Okay. Oops. Next awesome. Question. go ahead and pick again.
How about 80s music for 100?
All right, good choice. What duo lost their Grammy for Best New Artist from the 80s? Gabby.
Milli Vanilli.
That is correct for 100 points. Very
nice.
Good.
Thanks.
All right, you can pick again.
Oh, okay. Summer Olympics for 100.
Good choice.
Thanks.
Where were the 2004 Summer Olympics held? Gabby.
In Greece.
What part of Greece?
Athens.
Correct. For 100 points. Pick
good
once
job,
again.
Daddy. I'll take 80s music for 200, please.
Okay. 80s music for 200. Who sang the line, "I want my MTV" on the Dire Straits song, "Money for Nothing"? And no, out of time. It was Sting.
Oh.
Sting.
No, I didn't
know that one. Not Stung. All
right. How about Summer Olympics for 200?
Summer Olympics for 200. Where were the first Olympic Games held? Patrice.
In Greece. Athens, Greece.
Athens, Greece, correct.
Awesome.
Correct.
Good job.
All right. Your pick. Oh,
okay. TV shows for 200, please.
Okay. What 80s TV show starred Tom Hanks in women's clothing? That's it. Out of time. It was Bosom Buddies. Yeah, wasn't Buzz, it was his big break.
Totally. No.
Mm. Yeah. Mm.
Sorry.
I think it was Patrice. Still has the board.
Summer Olympics for 300, please.
Summer Olympics for 300. What year did Atlanta, Georgia hold the Olympics?
2000?
Yeah. No, that is incorrect.
96?
Yes, that is correct.
Ooh, sorry.
Okay. And at the end, I don't know what the scores are, but everybody had some. So now it's time for commercial. Welcome back. Now, as we come back, Gabby has 200 points, Zoe has 300 points, and Patrice has 200 points. Let's take a moment to meet our contestants. Gabby. Tell us a little something about yourself. What kind of music do you like?
I like all kinds of music, Andy, except country.
That's neat.
It is neat.
Okay. And Zoe, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself? Where are you from?
I knew this was coming. I'm British, but I was born in Belgium, and I moved here 6 years ago.
Ah. Do you think it would be cool if people said Belgium, like, as if, you know, like Belgian waffles, like they're an extra good waffle. So if we just said like, you know, this is an extra good thing, that was a totally Belgium.
That would be awesome.
All right.
We should.
Moving on.
Let's start that.
That would be Belgium.
Okay, cool. Cool, all right, Patrice, why don't you tell us what your favorite subject in high school was?
Criminal justice.
You had criminal justice in high school?
I did.
That's neat.
I did. We watched a lot of TV.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Like Cops or what?
Law and Order.
All right.
Things like that.
We'll move right along then.
That's not
okay. Good. All right, we're still in the same round. We got the same categories. Zoe is in the lead, so we'll let her go ahead and pick.
TV shows for 300, please.
Okay. What is SpongeBob's pet snail's name?
Oh.
Gabby.
Gary.
That is correct.
Watch that.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh.
What is yours?
Okay. Let's do TV shows for 400.
Mm.
All right. Which patron has a key to the bar on the show Cheers? Time's up. It was Norm.
Oh.
Norm. Yes.
Should've known that.
All right.
Yeah. No.
Still your board.
80s music for 300, please.
Okay. All right. What was Eddie Murphy's hit in his brief singing career?
I should.
Eddie Murphy.
Oh, we were just watching this on TV.
I know.
Oh. Time's up, and you should all be proud you don't know this. It was Party All the Time.
That's right.
Right.
My girl likes to party all the time.
Only you would know
Maybe
that.
You shouldn't be so proud of that. All right, go ahead.
Summer Olympics for 400.
Okay. When was the last time both the Summer and Winter Olympics took place in the same year? Time's up. Okay. And the answer was 1992. Okay, keep going, whoever was whatever.
TV shows for 500.
All right. Which bar does Drew Carey and his pals hang out at?
Uh-huh.
Time's up again. It's TV shows, it's not, you know, hard stuff.
We don't watch TV.
All right, anyway, that's the end of that category. Gabby, once again.
80s music for 400.
All right. Which band produced the soundtrack to Flash Gordon?
Queen.
Correct. Ooh, very good. Queen knowledge goes over well with me. All right. Go ahead, pick. Two more categories left.
Oh. 80s music, please.
All right. 500. Which band released the album Ghost in the Machine?
No.
Time's up. It was The Police. Oh. The Police.
Yes.
All right, and the final question is, Summer Olympics for 500. Who came up with the idea of the Olympic torch?
Isn't it Achilles?
No, that's wildly incorrect. Either of you have a guess?
No.
No.
Would you believe it's Hitler?
Oh, so far.
It was Hitler. All right, and at the end of round one, Gabby has 500 points, Zoe has 700, Muscular Ooh. 700, and Patrice is eliminated with only 200 points. So, let's go around. With a brave, out free lover, so come ride with me to the distant show. We won't. Welcome back to the game show. I'm here with Gabby, our winner, who has 2,000 points, which now mean nothing, but she has them. So we're going to do our final round here, but let's go to Brad real quick to remind us what the prize is.
Again, Andy, Gabby is playing for $20 towards Giant Food Stores. Giant on Route 309. All right, back to you, Andy.
Thanks, Brad. That sounds fabulous. Awesome. All right. All right, we're going to cut you a little bit of a break here. If you get 9 out of 10 of these right, you get the card. Okay?
Awesome.
But if you get any less than that, you get to leave.
Okay.
Nothing. All right. Let's go.
All right.
What was the date man landed on the moon?
February 2nd.
Let's give us the year.
19, I don't know.
Wrong. All right, that was your free one. You're still looking great. All right. What is the name of King Arthur's sword?
I have no idea. Who knows these?
Let's keep going. We'll add up the score later. All right. According to Nostradamus, World War III will last how long?
What?
How many boroughs are there in New York City?
5.
Yes. Where was WKRP located?
Pittsburgh.
No. What shape is on the side of the Dallas Cowboys helmet?
star.
Yes, what is the capital of Illinois?
Chicago.
Wrong. How many home runs did Hank Aaron hit in his career? Which amendment to the Constitution allows freedom of speech?
The first.
How many lakes are there? Yes, that's correct, by the way. How many lakes are there in the Great Lakes?
Five.
What song have I had stuck in my head all day?
My girl likes to party all the time.
Oh, very close though. Very close. It was Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting by Elton John. All right.
So I don't win.
You didn't get squat.
No.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
All right, that's it for the game show. Tune in next time when we have Brian back and it'll be lots of fun.
All right, thank you everybody for watching the game show. We'd like to thank all the contestants for coming out today. And if you'd like to be a contestant, please contact Joe Voorhees. You'll see him around if you want.
Season. I am your host, Brian, and we have contestants Tara, Jim, and Andy. Our game is pretty simple. We've got three wonderful categories in the first round: gambling, periodic table, and Jim Brewer. The person with the least amount of points at the end of the first round will be kicked off, and then the second round will be the lightning round, and the winner at the end of that round will go into the final round to win a $25 gift certificate at Giant. Andy, you won the coin toss backstage. Why don't you go ahead and pick a category?
All right, I'll take gambling for 100, please.
Okay. In Hearts, what is it called when you collect every trick? Tara.
Shooting the moon.
Correct.
I'll go for gambling for 200.
Okay. What two values does the ace have in blackjack? Andy.
1 and 11.
Correct. You're bored.
Great, I'm losing already.
Gambling for 300.
Okay, big gamblers. What is it called when a poker player bets the rest of his money?
All in.
Correct.
Gambling for 400.
Okay. What color is zero on the roulette wheel?
Green.
Correct.
Gambling for 500.
If you pick a horse to show, what does this mean? Andy.
Third place.
Are we going to take that? Yes, we'll take that. Oh, just barely. Okay, Andy, pick another one.
We gotta go with Jim Brewer for 100, please.
All right. Tough one here. Where did Jim Brewer perform on October 4th? Please let me finish the question. October 4th, 2004. Jim.
DeSales.
Correct. You're bored.
All right, Jim Brewer for 200.
Okay.
Back in the game.
What movie starred Jim Brewer and Dave Chappelle?
Half Baked.
Correct.
Jim Brewer for 300.
On which show did Jim Brewer's Goat Boy become famous?
Saturday Night Live.
Correct.
Jim Brewer for 400.
All right. Jim Brewer's comedy special, Hardcore, combined comedy and what? Jim.
Music.
Correct. Okay, we're going to go to a commercial break. We'll be back in a little bit with the rest of the first round. Game show. Halfway through our first round, the scores are former host Andy at 1,000, returning loser Tara at 1,000 as well, and Jim in behind with 500. And we're going to take a little time to get to know the contestants now. Before the show, they tell the producers a little something about themselves, and we have them talk about it on the show. Now, Tara, you've been here twice before and lost pretty bad both times, including one famous loss to a puppet.
I didn't lose bad.
I've heard that since then, scientists have replaced your brain with some sort of inexpensive cheese.
Monster.
Is that responsible for your improvement?
Monster cheese. It's the good stuff.
Okay. Good stuff. Good cheese in your brain.
Yes.
Okay. We're all very proud. Jim.
Yes.
You said on numerous occasions that you talk to your dog because people don't understand you. Would you care to explain that?
Well, yeah, that's true. Well, my dog just... We connect on a level I don't connect with other dogs, so...
Yeah, you're crazy.
You know, it's a lot easier.
Yeah.
You know, people are just weird.
Yeah, and Andy, your insatiable hunger for cocaine has led you to kidnap children and sell them to black market fur traders. You want to tell us something about that?
Yeah, it's surprising the amount of fur you can get off of a small child.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hairy little beast, huh? Mm. Yeah. Okay. Kind of sick, too. All right, we're back. I think, Andy, you had the board?
Sure,
so
why not?
So go ahead and pick a category.
Let's go ahead and get it out of the way. Jim Brewer for 500.
All right, let's get it out of the way. In 2002, Jim Brewer appeared on Late Night with Conan O'Brien as what? Jim.
As Joe Pesci?
Incorrect. Tara?
As Goat Boy?
Incorrect. Just a reminder, you don't lose points for an incorrect answer, so feel free to guess anything.
As a guest host?
No. As the lips of Ozzy Osbourne. The lips of Ozzy Osbourne. No, Jim, you can't buzz in twice. Yeah, we're not just giving this away. Okay, since you all failed so miserably, I'll pick the next one. How about periodic table for 100? Okay. What is the first element on the periodic table?
Hydrogen.
Correct.
Periodic table for 200.
What element has the symbol O? Tara.
Oxygen.
Correct.
I think my buzzer works.
No, it didn't. You're just slow. What element has the symbol K? Jim.
Does that mean potassium?
Potassium is correct.
Reset.
You're bored.
I will have periodic table for 400.
Okay. What is the symbol for helium?
He.
Correct. All right. Yes. And periodic table for 500. What element has the symbol Au? Jim.
Gold.
Correct.
Yes.
Well, that's the end of our first round. We'll be back after a short commercial break with the second round, the lightning round of the game show. Welcome back to the game show once again. As you can see, Andy is no longer with us. He has, in fact, been a loser and has proven himself unworthy of the second round, the lightning round. But we do still have Tara and Jim here. Jim in the lead with 1,700 points. Yeah. Tara lagging behind with 1,300. Will she lose for a third time? Okay, let's go ahead and start with kids' shows. What does SpongeBob live in? Tara.
A pineapple under the sea.
Correct. What does Velma say when she finds something interesting?
Jinkies.
Correct. Pinky and the Brain was a spinoff of what other kids show?
Animaniacs.
Correct. What company did the coyote get his gadgets from?
Acme.
Correct. What is the name of Big Bird's teddy bear? Big Bird's teddy bear. Jim.
Snuffy?
No.
Oh, he's the big elephant.
That thing was gigantic. Tara.
Snickerdoodle?
No.
Okay.
That might cost you points.
No, it can't.
Okay, the answer was radar. Radar.
Radar.
Let's move on to hobbies. This hobby is the Japanese art of folding paper.
Origami. Jim.
Correct. How many sides to the Rubik's Cube? All right, we'll start that one over. We had a little problem with the buzzers here. How many sides?
Right, you have to finish the question. Oh,
six.
Fair.
Six? Yeah, we'll take it.
I lose because of that.
We'll take it.
Torching the set.
Shut up. What are the red squares on a Scrabble board worth?
3 points?
Are we taking it?
Oh, triple, sorry. Triple, three?
No. You know what, no.
Okay,
triple. Triple word score, yes, correct, yeah. Jim. Damn Jim it. Gets the points. How many squares does the king move in chess when castling?
One.
No.
Never heard of castling.
Two.
Correct.
Oh, I never even played chess.
Two.
I never heard of castling. It's crap.
And the final question of the lightning round.
All right.
What year was the first Ford Mustang produced?
Oh. I don't know, 69?
Incorrect. Tara?
66.
Incorrect. 1964
damn,
and a half. Okay, let's total up the scores. How do you guys think
time.
You did?
I think I lost for my third and final time.
I think I won, yep. Actually.
I have
that
say
sounds
I lost.
About right.
Yep.
In your face.
Hate you.
Probably not going to break the streak.
At least you're not a puppet.
Mm. Yeah, am I?
But you still did lose to a puppet. We're never gonna forget that.
Yeah.
That is a crappy paper airplane, Bill. Okay. And the final scores. Tara, with 2,800. Jim, with 3,700. Tara loses again.
Yes.
All
yes.
Right, Jim, you move
Coming
on
back.
To the final round. We'll be back after this commercial break
start.
And see if Jim can win a $25 gift certificate to Giant Foods. Game show for our final round with Jim here, who is playing for a $25 gift certificate to Giant Foods. I also have a saw. No one here knows where I got it or what I plan to do with it, so keep that in mind. Are you ready for the extreme final round?
As ready as I'll ever be.
Okay. 7 questions.
Out of 10.
Out of 10 for the certificate.
Get it.
Question number 1. Is Chardonnay a red wine or a white wine?
Red.
Who opened for Jim Brewer at DeSales University?
What was his name? Jesse Adams.
Whose term as president lasted only 31 days?
Garfield.
Where did the Wright brothers accomplish flight for the first time?
Mississippi.
Which team had the best record in Major League Baseball this season?
Yankees.
Who played Winston in the Ghostbusters?
Winston. Oh, wasn't Mary. It was a Bass. I don't know.
Who wrote Catcher in the Rye?
J.D. Salinger.
What play is currently in production at DeSales?
The Foxes. The Little Foxes.
Who does the voice of Chris Griffin in Family Guy?
Seth Green.
Spell xylophone.
X-Y-L-O-P-H-O-N-E.
Okay, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 questions correct. Not enough for the giant gift certificate, but you narrowly escaped the saw. So...
I didn't even want to.
You should feel glad that you managed to keep Tara in the loser's bracket and avoid the saw. We'll be back in another 2 weeks with another episode of the game show. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the game show.
Hello and welcome to the game show once again. I'm your host, Brian, and our contestants are Brian, Aaron, and Anthony. Okay, we got an easy game tonight. We got three categories in the first round. The two winning contestants at the end of the first round will go into the second round, the lightning round, where the winning contestant from that round will go into the final round to win a gift certificate. Okay. Anthony, you won the coin toss backstage. Why don't you go ahead and go first?
All right, I'll go for Around Sports for 200.
Shaquille O'Neal was traded to this team in the offseason.
The Lakers.
Incorrect.
The Hornets.
Incorrect again.
The Bulls.
Incorrect a third time. The Miami Heat. Okay, since nobody got that, Anthony, go ahead and choose another category.
Good guess. Since we're doing so well, Around Sports for 300.
Who has the most walk-off hits in baseball playoff history?
Tara Lipinski.
Minus 100 points.
Barry Bonds.
Incorrect.
Okay. Shaquille O'Neal.
Incorrect. The answer is David Ortiz. Anthony.
All right, we're going to switch categories for child stars for 200.
This actress received her first Academy Award nomination at 13 for her role in Taxi Driver.
Mary-Kate Olsen?
Incorrect.
Ashley Olsen.
I don't like either one of them. Anthony.
Anna Paquin.
No.
Okay.
Jodie Foster. Jodie Foster.
We were close.
Okay, I'm just going to pick an easy one for you guys.
Yeah, please.
Child stars for 300. This child star received $8 million for his role in Richie Rich. Anthony.
Macaulay Culkin.
All right. Finally. Okay, go ahead and pick another category.
Child stars for 400.
Okay. This actor played a young Indiana Jones and had a promising career until he died in 1993 in front of the Viper Room.
River Phoenix.
Correct.
Nice.
Good job, man.
Child stars for 500.
This actor owned the Viper Room.
Johnny Depp.
Correct.
Nice.
Finish off the category for child stars for 100.
This star of the Partridge Family has been arrested numerous times for drug possession.
Danny Bonaduce.
Correct. Okay, go ahead and pick another category.
Around Sports for 400.
Okay. What all-time leading NFL receiver was recently traded to the Seahawks? Okay. Name a prominent NFL player that you're familiar with.
Donovan McNabb.
No, incorrect. He's a quarterback.
Dan Marino.
Incorrect. Okay, the answer was Jerry Rice. Now we're going to go to commercial.
Okay.
We'll come back with the scores in just a minute. Okay, welcome back to the game show. All right, our scores after the first half of the first round are Brian losing with negative 100 points, Aaron not too far ahead with 0 points, and Anthony in the lead with 1,300 points. At least somebody's trying. Okay, let's get to know the contestants now. We talked to each of the contestants before the show, found out a little something about them. Brian, now you said that what you lack in shoulders, you make up for in hugs and deep, passionate, bottled-up rage.
Absolutely, Brian. It's an inner secret of mine, and I felt this is the best
Dangerous.
Way to express it.
Yeah. Okay. Aaron, you claim to possess the ability to summon your own walrus friend to help you in times of trouble.
That's right. His name is Ken Jennings.
Will Ken Jennings be coming today?
Unfortunately, no. He's on vacation this week.
It seems like you might need him.
That's right.
Because you haven't been answering many questions.
That's right. Yeah. Well, I've been answering, just not correctly.
Yeah. Okay, and Anthony, you claim that your greatest accomplishment was traveling to outer space as an astronaut, although our sources said this is the first time you've left your hometown of Fobblesburg, Louisiana, where your best friend is a mounted moose's head.
Yeah, I must say my life is pretty sad, and I have no one.
Yeah. Well, at least you have a lot of time to study trivia, I guess, because you're winning.
Yeah, apparently.
Maybe get a little gift certificate, take it home, throw a little party. Yeah?
Yeah.
A little party? Mm-hmm. That'd be good. All right. Well, Anthony, why don't you pick a category to start us off for the next half of this round?
All right. Simpsons for 300.
Okay. What are the names of Marge's sisters? Aaron.
Thelma and Louise.
Incorrect. Those are the names of two movie heroines from the movie Thelma and Louise.
I tried.
All right, time's up. It was Patty and Selma.
Oh.
Patty and Selma.
Yeah.
All right. Anthony, care to choose another category?
Okay. Simpsons for 200.
Okay. Who is the superintendent of schools in Springfield? The superintendent of schools in Springfield. The superintendent of schools in Springfield.
Maggie Simpson.
The superintendent of schools in Springfield.
Mr. Burns.
Incorrect.
Mr. Superintendent.
Superintendent Chalmers. The answer is Superintendent Chalmers, okay? Anthony, care to pick another category?
All right, around sports for 500.
Okay. What quarterback has thrown 10 touchdowns in his last two games?
Drew Bledsoe?
Incorrect. Anthony?
Tom Brady?
Incorrect.
Donovan McNabb?
Incorrect. Incorrect. Anthony?
All right, Simpsons for 100.
Okay. What is Bart's favorite TV show?
The Itchy and Scratchy Show.
Are we going to accept that? Yes, we'll accept that. Okay. Anthony, another category.
Around sports for 100.
All right. Which of the four major sports is currently locked out? Anthony.
Hockey.
Correct.
Simpsons for 400.
Okay. What is the Simpsons phone number? None of you are going to get this, so I'm just going to say it. Aaron?
8675.
No. KL53226. KL53226.
KL.
Okay, and the last question of the round for 500, Simpsons for 500. In the episode that Homer is checked into a mental institution, Bart believes this pop star is coming to his house. Aaron?
Ricky Martin.
Incorrect. Anthony.
Britney Spears.
Incorrect.
Tara Lipinski.
Incorrect. The answer is Michael Jackson. Okay, let's get the scores before we go to the second round.
Yeah.
Okay, Brian is still at negative 100. Aaron is still at zero. And Anthony is at 1,500 in the lead. So when we come back, we're going to go to commercial break. We're going to come back to the second round where Brian will not be here because he's in negative points for the first time in game show history.
All right, Brian.
Okay, welcome back to the game show once again for the lightning round. Only Aaron and Anthony remain. Aaron, this is your chance to come back. If you can successfully master the categories Halloween and Geometry. Now, Anthony, you are in the lead, so go ahead and pick which category you'd like to go with first.
Halloween.
Okay. What fruit is often bobbed for at Halloween parties? Aaron.
Apples.
What was the name of the killer in the Halloween movies? Looks like we're having some technical difficulties. Okay.
Michael Myers.
Correct. Halloween occurs on the eve of this Christian holiday. Okay, we're having some technical difficulties again with the buzzers. Are we good with the buzzers?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna signify when you can buzz in.
Okay.
To answer the question. Now. Okay, Anthony.
All Saints Day.
Correct. Halloween originated with this European tribe.
The Celts.
Correct. Instead of Halloween, this country celebrates the Day of the Dead. Or El Día de los Muertos. Aaron.
Spain.
Incorrect.
El Día de los Muertos. Mexico.
Correct. Okay, on to geometry.
Yeah.
A stop sign has this geometric shape. Aaron.
Octagon.
Correct. What is the plural of radius? All right, stop. Okay. Again, I'm going to signify when you can buzz in. Now, Aaron.
Radii.
Correct. How do you find the area of a rectangle?
Length times the width.
Correct.
Yeah.
What is the formula to find the circumference of a circle?
Pi times diameter.
Correct. And the final question of the second round. What is a squared plus b squared equals c squared?
Is the Pythagorean theorem?
Correct. All right, let's add up the scores. How do you guys think you did?
I think he won.
You think he won?
Job it.
You might be surprised. You know, people come back in the second round. It's the lightning round.
Four answers.
That means anything can happen.
Anything's possible.
Even lightning.
If you believe, do you believe in magic?
All right, it's difficult to telling the scores. Okay. All right, and as it happens, Anthony is in fact the winner, quote, by a lot. So, Anthony, you'll be going on to the final round. We come back from commercial break. Aaron, you're going to be getting out of here because you lost. So we'll be back in a little bit. Welcome back to the game show for the final round. Anthony will be competing in the final round with 10 questions. He must answer 7 of these 10 questions to receive a $20 gift certificate from our sponsor, Giant Foods. Anthony, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. It's going to be intense.
Okay.
And if you answer them wrong, I'm going to put you in that fire.
I don't think I'll fit.
Time to begin. President Reagan's administration classified what school lunch food as a vegetable?
Tomato.
Who played Bluto in Animal House?
John Belushi.
The Great Barrier Reef is located off the coast of what country?
Australia.
What is the sequel to Alien called?
Alien 2.
Who wrote the following books? The Client and The Rainmaker.
John Grisham.
Val Kilmer played this musician in a movie directed by Oliver Stone. Okay, I'm going to move on.
Yeah.
Who played Jack on Three's Company?
John Ritter.
In chess, what piece must be changed when you reach the final row of your opponent's side?
Your king.
How long were the biblical floods?
40 days and 40 nights.
What country used to be called Persia?
Iraq.
Okay, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 questions right. Sorry, that's not enough for the giant gift certificate, but you did manage to avoid the fire, so a small victory.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you.
We'll be back in 2 weeks with another episode of the game show. Don't look now. Things just got worse. I'm drunk again, I swear this present. Welcome to the game show. We've got three contestants tonight, Chris, Hannah, and Kristen, all competing to win. We've got three categories in the first round. At the end of the first round, the two winners will move on to the second round, the lightning round, with two categories, and the winner of that round will move on to the final round for the grand prize. Okay, Chris, you won the coin toss backstage. Why don't you start us out?
Brian, I'm going to take spelling for 500.
Excellent choice. Okay. Spell Cincinnati.
Okay. Okay. Cincinnati. C-I-N-C-I-N-A-T-T-I.
Incorrect. Anna.
C-I-N-C-I-N-N-A-T-T-I.
Incorrect. Kristen.
C-I-N-C-I-N-A-T-T-I.
That was the same one Chris said. But thanks for trying, I guess. Okay. Chris, why don't you choose another one?
I'm going to go for a spelling for 400.
Brian. Sure about that.
I'm positive.
Okay. Circumference.
Circumference. C-I-R-C-U-M-F-R-E-N-C-E. Are you kidding me?
No, I'm not kidding you. You got it wrong.
C-I-R-C-U-M. F-E-R-E-N-C-E.
Correct. You're bored. Pick a category.
I'm going to go for sports curses for 400.
Okay. It is believed that whoever appears on the cover of this magazine will suffer some unlikely circumstances in the near future.
Sports Illustrated?
Correct. Pick a category.
I'll go for famous cars for 500.
Okay. In Gone in 60 Seconds, Nicolas Cage had many failed attempts to steal the Mustang he called what? Chris.
Sally.
Incorrect.
Kristen. Heather?
Incorrect. You can't just guess a name. You're not going to get it right. Done. Kristen, choose another one.
Famous cars for 400.
Okay. Stephen King wrote a novel about a killer Plymouth named what?
I was out of time.
Chris.
Xanadu.
Incorrect. Christine. Name was Christine. Hey, pick another one.
Sports curses for 300.
Okay. The Chicago Cubs have not won a World Series since 19... Oh, wait. It is believed that they are cursed by this animal.
The bear?
Incorrect.
They're the Cubs. Weird things happen.
No, you're done. Okay. The answer is the billy goat. The billy goat.
Never would have got that.
Okay, I'm going to pick an easy one for you now. This is famous cars for 100. Michael Keaton, Val Kilmer, Chris O'Donnell, and George Clooney all drove this car.
The Batmobile?
Yes. Ooh. Okay, now we're going to go to commercial. Welcome back to the game show. The scores now are Kristen in the lead with 500, Hannah close second with 400, and Chris losing with zero.
Ouch.
Yep.
Okay, let's take some time to get to know the contestants. Chris, before the show, we asked you if you had any special talents. You said you were invisible, and we asked you why we could see you, and you just ran away.
That's true. I am invisible. And I'm sticking to it.
Okay. Hannah, I'd always heard that theater majors smelled like rotten mustard. However, you smell like rotten meat. Can you explain that?
It's just because I'm a higher quality. I'm better than everyone else.
Steak. Yeah, I got you. All right, and Kristen, I'm pretty sure you stole my sandwich, and if I have proof, I'm going to skin you. Okay, back to the show. Chris, why don't you choose a category?
I'm going to take spelling for 100, Brian.
Okay. All right, spell independence.
Independence. I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-C-E.
Correct. Way to grab that 100 points. See if you can pick up another.
That's right. I'm going to take spelling for 200 if I'm on a roll.
All right. Bureaucracy. Chris.
Bureaucracy. B-U-R. E-A-U. Wait, hang on. Bureaucracy. B-U.
You get 3 tries, I'm going to say.
All right.
This is number 3.
Bureaucracy. B. U. R. E. R. A. C. R. A. C. Y.
Whatever. Get out of here.
Yeah.
Anybody else? Hannah.
B. U. E. A. R. A. C. Y.
Incorrect. Kristen.
B. U. E. R. A. C.
Incorrect. The answer was B. U. R. E-A-U-C-R-A-C-Y, clearly. Please pick another category.
Spelling for 300.
Okay. Benign.
Benign. B-E-N-I-G-N.
Okay, that was correct. Go ahead and pick another one.
Sports curses for 500.
Okay. It is believed that the Chicago White Sox have not won a title since 1917, because of the team that threw the World Series in 1919. Name this curse.
The Braves.
Shut up. Kristen.
The Red Sox.
Incorrect. It is the curse of the Black Sox. Chris?
I was going to say another? Black Sox. Sports curses for 100.
You said the Braves. The Boston Red Sox finally broke this curse when they won their first World Series in 86.
The curse of the Bambino.
Correct. Pick another category.
Sports curses for 200, Brian.
It seems that whatever player appears on the cover of this video game sustains an injury at some point in the season. Chris.
Madden.
Correct.
Famous cars for 200.
Okay. David Hasselhoff drove a Pontiac Firebird that went by this name.
That show.
The car in Knight Rider.
We're going to turn off your buzzer. Anybody?
The car in Baywatch?
No.
The Knight Rider went to
the name was Kit, and you all lose 100 points. And famous cars for 300. In what movie did Steve McQueen drive a 68 Mustang? Famous car chase. What movie? Steve McQueen, 68 Mustang. Come on.
Bullet?
Correct.
Yes!
Okay.
Just came to me.
Before we go to commercial break, let's tally up the scores. See who's going on in the second round, all right? We've got a piece of paper here from our scorekeeper, Bill Vargo. And in the lead, well, why don't we start at the end, actually? Losing, and we'll not go on to next rounds. Hannah with 400. Second place, Kristen with 500. Neither of them got any points the second half of this round. And in the lead, Chris with 1,300. Quite a commendable comeback. All right, we'll go to commercial break. We'll be back with the second round. I'm
bouncing off the walls again. Whoa,
welcome back to the game show again. For the second round, where Chris and Kristen will be competing in this lightning round with the categories presidential candidates and Disney World attractions. Okay, Kristen, why don't you go ahead and choose a category to start off with?
Disney World attractions.
Okay. This ride inspired a blockbuster movie starring Johnny Depp.
Pirates of the Caribbean.
Correct, sorry. Which ride takes place in an elevator in an old hotel?
Chris. Tower of Terror.
Correct. How many water parks are located inside Disney World?
Three.
Correct.
That's good, that's pretty good.
What is the tallest mountain in the Magic Kingdom?
Splash Mountain?
Incorrect.
I know.
Chris?
The Matterhorn?
Incorrect. Big Thunder Mountain.
Thunder. I was going to say that.
Right, oh, you didn't say it. All right. And the final question, what is the name of the 3D feature film at Epcot? Chris.
Oh, come on.
Honey, I Shrunk the Audience.
Thank you.
Correct.
I'm...
All right.
I'm mad you buzz faster
Kristen,
than me.
Not really pulling away. You're going to have to answer a lot of these correct. Presidential candidates.
Well, I'll let you go.
I might as well resign now.
Ready?
Yeah.
You ready?
Kristen.
Because we're about to start.
All right. Competitive here.
In 1996, Bill Clinton was opposed by what Republican candidate?
Oh, no, I don't know.
1996, the Republican candidate.
Oh.
Al Gore? No.
Incorrect.
Bob Dole?
Yes, and minus 100 for okay.
Let's get it together.
I told you I wasn't going to do this.
Kristen.
All right.
Which Democratic candidate ran against George W. Bush in 2000?
I don't know. I don't know!
Correct. Okay. In 1976, Gerald Ford was opposed by whom in the presidential election?
Wait, could you repeat the question?
Yes, I could. In 1976, Gerald Ford was opposed by whom in the presidential election?
Jimmy Carter.
Correct. Okay, let's just keep going with this for the second tradition. Which the first debate was televised in 1960. Who were the candidates participating?
I thought I know.
Chris.
Kennedy and Nixon?
Correct.
I did know one of them.
And the first presidential debates took place between Abraham Lincoln and who?
John Wilkes Booth.
Yes, John Wilkes Booth. Correct.
Good job.
Well played.
You stole my Disney World questions. You wanted to give me the presidential candidates. You wouldn't
we'll accept
just
John
let me answer
Booth.
The Disney
All
World
All right,
questions
we're tallying up the scores. How do you guys think you did?
I don't know. You know what, Brian? I don't know how I did. I'm just going to wait
Can
for the
Can I have
results.
More Disney World questions?
Oh, that was a pretty poor paper.
I knew all those
it's gonna be
except
close.
For the one
it's
I answered wrong.
All right.
It's going to be close. I can feel it.
I buzzed in, but
okay, whoa. Kristen with 1,500, and Chris with 4,300. So it looks like Chris will be going on to the final round to compete for a $20 gift certificate to Giant. We'll see you after this commercial. Welcome back to the game show. We're here with Chris in the final round where he'll compete to win a $20 gift certificate to Giant. He has to answer 7 of the 10 questions correctly to win. Chris, are you ready?
Yes, I'm
okay.
Ready.
What continent does the Nile River run through?
Africa.
True or false, a group of lions are called a pride?
True.
What is the biggest state in the USA?
Texas.
Which is taller than the Empire State Building or the Statue of Liberty?
The Empire State Building.
Who sang the song My Way?
Usher.
What is the longest bone in the human body?
The tibia.
True or false, Neptune is closer to the sun than Jupiter?
Repeat the question.
True or false, Neptune is closer to the sun than Jupiter? True or false?
False.
Naples is located in what country?
Oh, Italy.
Magellan discovered what ocean?
The Indian.
Who made the first solo flight across the Atlantic?
The Wright brothers?
Incorrect. Okay, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 questions correct. Not enough to win the giant gift certificate, but enough to save you from being devoured by my rabbit.
Thank God. Thank God.
Okay, we'll be back in 2 weeks with another episode of The Game Show. Thank you for joining us. Hello and welcome to The Game Show, our final episode of the season. We have with us here tonight, Steven, someone whose name I haven't been told, and Joe. Our categories are musicians, Hollywood, and Christmas. Steve, why don't you pick the first category?
I'm a jolly kind of fellow. I think I'm going to go with Christmas for 100.
Okay, Christmas for 100. What day of the year is usually the busiest shopping day?
Black Friday.
Are we taking it? Oh, we're taking it. We're taking it.
Oh.
Okay, Joe, pick another category.
Christmas 200.
All right. Who wrote A Christmas Carol?
Charles Dickens.
Correct. Correct. Pick another category.
300 Christmas.
What did the Grinch use to pull his sleigh?
A dog dressed as a reindeer.
Correct.
Let's keep going with Christmas.
All right, in the spirit. At Christmas, it is traditional to exchange kisses beneath...
Mistletoe.
For future reference, I'd like to finish the question.
Oh, okay.
If that's possible, if you can wait, you know.
I'm sorry.
Maybe I'd like to finish the question. Okay. Minus 100 points.
No.
But you can pick a category.
Hollywood for 200.
Okay. The Godfather was adapted from a novel by what author?
Cujo.
Correct. Bored, Joe.
Christmas 500.
All right. How many drummers drumming did my true love give?
To me. 11.
Incorrect. That's what you get for buzzing in her. You're wrong.
12 drummers drumming.
Correct. Also, what's your name?
Mickey.
Thank you. All right, it's your board, Mickey.
Musicians for 300.
Okay. In the Grateful Dead song, who was riding that train high on...
Oh. All right.
We're going to stop doing this. Riding that train high on cocaine.
Casey Jones.
Correct. Okay. We're going to go to commercial break. We'll be back with the scores. Oh, hello. Welcome back. We're going to get to know the contestants real quick before we go on with the game. We asked all the contestants, in the spirit of Christmas, what their number one Christmas wish was this year. Steve said to own a hippopotamus. Certainly a wonderful imagination, Steve. Yeah, hippopotamus. Mickey said the taste of human flesh. Kind of creepy. And Joe said manhood. Manhood. Something you need, Joe. Okay. I believe Mickey had the board when we left. Why don't you go ahead and pick a category?
I'll take musicians for 500.
Okay. Courtney Love starred in The People vs. Larry Flint. What is the name of her band?
Hole.
Correct.
Hollywood 100.
Who starred in Singin' in the Rain and An American in Paris? Singin' in the Rain and An American in Paris.
No, I know.
Incorrect. It was clearly Gene Kelly. Clearly Gene Kelly. Joe, pick another cat.
All right, Hollywood for 300.
Who won Best Actress for her role in As Good As It Gets?
Helen Hunt.
Correct. Pick a category.
Hollywood for 500.
Okay. Actress Talia Shire is what film director's sister? Talia Shire.
Coppola.
Correct. Correct. Okay.
400.
Hollywood for 400?
That's okay. Correct.
What did Fred McMurray invent in The Absent-Minded Professor?
A flying car?
No. Well, are we going to take that? We take flying car? No, we're not taking flying car. That was a bad answer. The answer was flubber.
Oh.
Flubber. Okay.
I just didn't hit the button.
Go ahead and pick another category.
100 musicians.
Mick Jagger was married to what supermodel? Mick Jagger married to what supermodel? Supermodel Jerry. Too late. Too late. No. Can you give me the last name?
Schiffer?
No. No. Supermodel Jerry Hall. Okay. I'm just going to go down these last two. Musicians for 200. Whose 80s signature song was Girls Just Want to Have Fun?
Cyndi Lauper.
Correct. And the last question of the round for 400. What is the name of country singer Garth Brooks' pop music alter ego? Garth Brooks' pop music alter ego. Chris Gaines. The answer is Chris Gaines. Okay, we're going to get the scores before we go to commercial break. Thank you, Chris. Ooh. Well, bringing up third place with 300 points, we got Steve. He's not coming back next round. In second place with 1,200 points, Mickey. And in first place with 1,500, Joe Mazarski. Quite a surprise, since he's pretty slow. We'll be back after this commercial break. Welcome back to the game show again. We're in our second round. Steve was the loser, and we've taken away his mic and given him a hat suiting his mental capacity. Our fine assistant Ed will be holding the categories, television and sports. And a reminder, the scores are Mickey with 1,200 and Joe with 1,500. Okay, Joe, you're in the lead. Why don't you start us off?
Television.
Okay. Who played Batman in the popular 60s TV series?
Adam West.
Correct. Correct. Greatest show ever, by the way. On Saturday Night Live, who played the wild and crazy guys? also known as the Czechoslovakian Bachelors. Czechoslovakian Bachelors. Wild and crazy. Czechoslovakian. Very wild and also very crazy. Wrong! Steve Martin and Dan Aykroyd. It was a very easy question, and I'm very ashamed of both of you. Who played the Beaver on Leave It to Beaver? And Jerry Mathers. Who played Mr. Spock?
Leonard Nimoy?
Correct. What was the name of Andy Kaufman's character on Taxi? Andy Kaufman's character on Taxi. Latka. Latka Kravitz. Okay, on the sports, Ed, you can drop television. Drop it. Drop it. Excellent. Okay, on the sports. What manager left the New York Yankees in 1995 before they went on to win 3 championships in 4 years? Buck Showalter. Buck Showalter. I can't believe you guys didn't know that. Buck Showalter. What golfer is known as the King?
Tiger Woods?
No.
Gary Player?
What?
Gary Player?
No. No. It was, well, it was Arnold Palmer. Chris the scorekeeper got it right.
I didn't think he was. That was
and
bullshit.
Said it, but Joe didn't listen.
No, I didn't think it was
so,
Arnold Palmer.
Shut up. You didn't get any points.
All right.
Okay. What championship figure skater was attacked with a pipe?
Nancy Kerrigan.
Correct. Correct. Yeah. Thoroughly attacked with a pipe. In 1993, what Philadelphia Phillies player wore the number 99, the highest number ever worn in a World Series? Come on. Number 99, Philadelphia Phillies.
Baseball stuff.
Don't tell me you don't know. Clearly, Mitch Williams. Clearly. Okay. Who set a record by hitting 5 home runs during the 1977 World Series? Record. 1977. Just think back.
Wait, do I lose
to 1977.
All right, Pete Rose?
No.
All right. I wanted to play.
He set a record for gambling on his own game. All right, I'm just going to say Reggie Jackson.
Oh.
And let's go ahead and total up the scores. We're not. Joe, okay, well, we're just going to say Joe won. So he will be moving on to the final round to win a $20 gift certificate to Giant and the chance to wear the totally awesome Joseph Stalin hat and probably kill a lot of people, as is the style of the hat. So, we'll be back in a little bit from this commercial.
I want to see the program monitor so I can see what up.
Welcome back to the game show for the final round. Now, Joe, you've made a triumphant journey from your childhood growing up under power lines to be the final contestant on the game show, playing for a $20 gift certificate to Giant, rights to the Joseph Stalin hat, and we've got a little bit more incentive. If you fail to answer at least 2 questions, we're going to hang you. And it's probably going to suck. So, without further build up, this is the final round. Are you ready?
Yep.
What's a row of crows called?
A row of what?
A row of crows.
Like the bird?
Yes, the bird.
A flock? Stop stalling. Flock? I don't know.
Whose hit song was Puff the Magic Dragon?
Oh, shit. Cat Stevens.
What country borders Norway and Finland?
Sweden.
What city has the most taxis in the world?
City?
City.
New York.
An eternal flame in Arlington Cemetery, which marks which president's grave?
JFK.
The color Coca-Cola was originally?
Black.
What person led the assassination plot against Caesar?
Oh, wait, hold on. Jesus.
We might have to hang you just for that. Who murdered rapper Christopher Wallace, also known by what name?
Notorious B.I.G.
What was gangster Al Capone's nickname?
Dirty Harry.
What kind of animal is the cartoon character Bullwinkle?
A moose.
Okay, Joe, you did escape hanging, but I don't think you got enough to get the gift certificate. You got 1, 2, 3, 4 correct. It's not going to get you a gift certificate.
Can I see the answers?
No, you can't see the answers. Get lost.
All right.
We'll be back next season with more of the game show. Thanks for joining us. Let's go. Walks further down the street.